हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू यूट्यूब चैनल ऑफ श्रीमती आर एस कालरिया प्राइमरी स्कूल। आई प्रियंका पुरोहित विल एक्सप्लेन यू यूनिट 4 ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 8 इंग्लिश टेस्ट। द यूनिट नेम इज एट द थिएटर। नाउ सी दैट एट द थिएटर मीन्स दैट हियर द पोएट वॉन्ट्स टू टेल यू दैट व्हेनेवर यू आर गो टू वॉच अ मूवी और ड्रामा एट द थिएटर दैट टाइम this condition is happening with you and that condition is what that suppose that you are have gone to watch a movie with your friend and that friend has already seen the movie and now then when he is coming with you that time and you are going first time so whenever the scene is coming on the screen that time before it the your friend is telling you that what is coming to the next and he is telling you that what is who is the murderer who what is the suspense of the story what the funny scene is coming to on the screen so that time you will not like it would you like it no we don't like it because we have given the we have purchased the ticket to see the movie and we want to enjoy it mostly that we want to enjoy it otherwise the charm will be spoiled if he will tell everything to us the charm will be spoiled so here in this poem the writer exactly want to say this but before explaining the poem I want to go with activity 1 the chief interest of a story or film lies in its element of suspense and mystery every time the main plot is the main thing of the story is its suspense and if the mystery or suspense is revealed us to us beforehand if it is told to us beforehand means ke without coming on the screen without coming performing on the stage by the players before it is said someone to us that time all its charm will be spoiled the revelation must come to us step by step as the story progresses the everything should be come step by step when the story progresses that time we like it very much some people who have seen a people play or a movie earlier are in the habit of talking aloud while watching it again when they are watching it again even not in the theater at home also when the movie is coming and we are watching first time then suppose your elder brother is telling you everything and its suspense is it's he reveals the suspense of the movie that time you will not like to sit in front of the TV now see they keep talking and telling what is going to happen next thus they ruin the charm of all those who are sitting around watching for the first time they are spoiling the charm of the movie and now you see that this is not a good manner this is a bad manner to irritate someone okay now see that activity 2 is given in your textbook and that is related to your rules of etiquette it is related to rules of etiquette there are some rules in our social life we are living there we have to follow some social rules because otherwise the people will not like us now see rules of etiquette are important for smooth social life we expect people to behave in certain ways if somebody is throwing garbage in front of your house then you will not like it you want to say him or her that not to throw over here because there is a dustbin you should throw the garbage in the dustbin so that time we don't like it so that we want that the people behave in a certain ways if they do not they hurt our feelings and cause an inconvenience or disturbance they create an inconvenience and disturbance in our life here are a few example of annoying manners lacking in etiquette talking very loudly in public places if the person is talking very loudly in public places that time they are also creating a misbehavior okay someone suppose that somebody is talking is on the mobile phone and he is speaking so loudly so who the person who is sitting near him ya fir who is walking on the road they will see that what's going on everybody we other people can listen so this is the bad manner smoking in buses and trains this is also the bad manner spitting on road and public places we should not do this we should not spit on the public places and on the roads throwing garbage anywhere. We should not throw garbage. If you are throwing, means that you, this is the lacking of etiquette. Entering somebody's premises without permission. If you are playing cricket and your ball has entered in the somebody's premises, that time you have to go there, but without permission if you are going, so that is the bad manners. You should take permission and then you can take your things. Interrupting when two persons are talking. When the two persons are talking and you are going asking them the question and you are not listening, you are not waiting, that is the bad manners. If your parents are talking, then you have to wait for them, okay, and then you go for it. Now you have to make the list of act of behavior you consider to be improve or annoying. Means that you want to consider, you want to find that the people also do behave like this. So that we should not listen the music on a high volume. If you are living in an apartment, that time you should not do like this. You should not disturb others when if somebody is studying. Okay, you should follow the rules of your society, and then many others are there which we have to follow. Now come to the activity 3. Activity 3, in the activity 3, here the writer is saying that undesirable behavior in the classroom and school. What will be the undesirable behavior? To make a paper ball and throw on your classmate, or to talk when the teacher is teaching you in the class, that time you talk with a neighbor and you discontinuously disturb the teacher with asking the foolish question, okay, and then don't wish to teacher, talk about the teacher and make prank, then these all are the misbehavior. To draw the ugly pictures on the benches, to write your name, to spoil the walls, these all are the misbehavior by the students which are done in the class. Now come to the activity 4, and that is at the theater to the lady behind me. At the theater, here it is written by A.P. Herbert, and here it is telling to the lady who is sitting behind him. The lady who is sitting behind me, the me is for Herbert. A.P. Herbert went to see the drama, and that time a lady who was sitting behind him was continuously telling about the story, the drama of the play. And now then it was how it is irritating the writer, that it is telling to us. The lady who was continuously talking about the scene which was coming in the drama. So now that time the writer, the poet was annoying, and how he behaves, that we say. What he says to her: dear madam, you have seen this play. I ever saw it till today. Here it is saying that dear madam, you have seen this play and I have ever saw it till today. Means I have never seen it till today. You have seen this play before. You know the details of the plot. You know the details of the plot. Plot means the series of events of a play. Play which are coming continuously one by one. You have seen the drama, so you know the plot of the story. But let me tell you that I do not. I have not seen this drama before. So let me tell you that I have not seen it. So please keep your mouth shut. Now students, here the figure of speech is used in these two lines last, and that is internal rhyme. This full poem is on the internal rhyme poem, where internal rhyme is the figure of speech in which the rhyming words are used. You know the details of the plot, but let me tell you, I do not. Plot not, play today. So these are the rhyming words which are used in this first paragraph. So we can say. And second thing, let me tell you, I do not. Do not means negative word is using in this sentence. So when the negative sentence, negative word is used, no and not, in the statement, that time that figure of speech is called the litotes. Okay, that is called litotes when the negative statement is given by the poet. The author seeks to keep from me the murderer's identity. The author wants to keep some secret, because if he will reveal the murderer's identity before the story. That time it will spoil the charm. So he wants to keep it secret and he wants to give us at the last of the end of the story. So, and you are not a friend of his, and I think that you are not his friend. So you are helping him. If you keep shouting who it is, so you are telling this, that who is the murderer, who is the murderer. You are saying continuously, so you should not tell him that who is the murderer of the story. Okay, the author, the actors in their funny way have several funny things to say. Whenever in the movie or in the drama when the funny scene is created by the players, that time you will see, by the actors, that time you will see that they are having some funny things to say and that they make us laugh. But if you will tell me the funny scene, the funny create things beforehand, then it will not amuse me. They will not be amuse me very much. So he is saying that the actors in their funny way have several funny things to say. They are having many things to say, but they do not amuse me more. They will not entertain me more if you have said them just before. But if you will say me beforehand, if you will tell me everything before the scene, that time they will not amuse me more. The merit of the drama lies here. Just look on the glossary. Merit means word. Okay, the main thing, the word of the drama is lies. I understand in some surprise. It is hidden in some surprise. If the surprise will be at the last of the drama, then we will be able to sit on the chair. But the surprise now must be small. It will be small since you have just foretold all. If you will tell us everything before it, foretold means told beforehand. If you will say everything before it, then this drama, this suspense will be very small. Then you will not enjoy it, obviously. The lady you have brought with you, now the lady who was continuously speaking behind the right poet, that time one more lady was coming with her and she was her niece. So she was telling to everything to her niece. So the right poet is saying, the lady you have brought with you is, I infer means I have decided, I thought that she is half-wit. Half-wit means stupid. I think that she is stupid too, but can understand the piece without assistance from your niece. Why? I can understand the drama myself. I don't want the help of your niece, because if the lady was not having any relative with her, that time she will not tell to anybody else. But his niece were with that lady, so she was telling everything to her and it was her working just like her assistant. So he said that I don't want any assistant who can tell me the suspense of the story. So I want that she is stupid. Obviously, if your friend is continuously telling you, that time you should tell him to keep his mouth shut. Otherwise, you will not enjoy the movie. In short, foul woman. Foul means here the meaning is mannerless. The person who is not having manner, here it is saying foul. Otherwise, bad. The meaning is bad, but here the meaning is mannerless. Foul woman, it would suit me just as well if you were mute. It will suit, this drama will suit to me if you will keep your mouth shut. If you will be mute, if you will be silent, then I can enjoy the drama. In fact, to make my meaning plain, in fact, I want to tell you plainly, clearly, that I trust you will not speak again. I can trust you that now, after telling me these whole words, you will not speak again. And may I add one human touch? Now here the writer is asking a question, but he does not want any answer. This is called interrogation figure of speech. When the poet, when the writer doesn't want any answer to, it is just to give the effect in the poetry that question is asked. So he said that, and may I add one human touch, means can I tell you something, can I tell you a manner, that don't breathe upon my neck so much, don't sit so close to me. Okay, here my neck means that only she is not breathing on his neck. It means whatever she is speaking, she is the poet is listening everything. So he said that he is giving advice that you don't sit near to me, you don't breathe upon me, I am not able to enjoy the drama. So he is saying at last that don't breathe upon my neck so much. Now here I want to draw your attention that the last line is the figure of speech of synecdoche. Synecdoche is a figure of speech in which the a part stands for whole and a whole stands for a part. Okay, it means they don't breathe upon my neck. So my neck means here he is not breathing, means she is sitting very close to him. So it can say that the she is means whole part is considered over here. Even the neck is here, it is on the poet is refer only for the neck. So here we can say that it is the figure of speech synecdoche is used. So in this poem, the internal rhyme, litotes, repetition of words are there. Funny things, funny is used. The actors in their funny way have several funny things to say. So internal rhyme, funny is used. So repetition is there. Anastrophe is there where the grammatical order was not proper, and the last is synecdoche is used in this poem. So I explained you the poem in which the poet is saying that this is a bad manner to reveal the everything beforehand if the person is watching everything first time. Okay students, in your this lesson one activity is given, activity 9, that I will explain you. Actually, it is based on the literature. Find out the difference between the following types of different literature. Here, the words are given, that is literature words are given. And what is the difference in them? That is, we have to tell. Write one or two sentences on each different type. So now I will explain you what is the difference between these two or these all words. Now see. That first word, that is the major form. Here we have to differentiate between the major form and genre. Okay, the first is novel. What is called novel? We all read many of the times, but actually we don't know the meaning of this word. Novel is a work of fiction, generally printed in a book form. It is printed in a book form. It is a long story. It is a kind of prose. Usually in a form of a story, where the long story is given in a book form, printed form, so that book is called novel. Okay, so novel is a work of fiction where the hero, heroines and many characters are there who are performing, and the story is very long and it is divided into many parts. Okay, so that is called novel. Second is poem. A literary composition in the form of a verse. A literary composition in a form of a verse is called a poem. Just like I explain you right now. Okay, that is a poem. Generally, it is written in a rhyming method where the rhyming words are used in the poem, or some other poetic device is used. These all are figure of speech which I say. These all are the poetic device which is used in this poem. Now the third one is drama. A drama or a play is a piece of work, generally in a form of a dialogue. Drama work, whenever you go to see to watch the drama, that time you will see that the dialogue delivery by the actors. So that drama is that, it is a piece of work in a written form in which the players, the actors are speaking the dialogues, and it is written in the book. This work is written with the purpose of performance of on a stage by actors. Why we wrote drama? So that the actors can perform it on the stage. So there the main motive to write this drama is that the actors can perform it on the stage. Short story. A short story is a tale that tells about the particulars of an act or occurrence or course of events. It is generally a work of fiction. it is a work of fiction in which the short story is written. We know that many of the times in the magazine, in the newspaper, you are reading a story which is very short, but it is just for entertain you, and this is to written that tells about the particular act by the people, by the drama and all, okay, and the occurrence of the course of the events. If they want to say some events, that time they perform it as a story. Novella. A novella is a short novel. It is also called a novelette. Okay, so this is called novella, is a form of the short novel. Novel is big and novella is a short form. Now come to the genre. Genre means the major form. In major form, what type of things can be used? Comedy can be there, suspense can be there, everything. So comedy is what? Comedy? Comedy is a light and humorous drama with a series of comic incidents that end happily. In the comic, you have read many comics. Okay, and even the comedy, if you will see that if the movie is comedy and all, so their ending will be good. If the suspense will be there, so there will be having a suspense in the story. Okay, a horror will be there, so you will be frightened by the writer. So here the comedy is a light that humorous drama with a series of comic features. There are continuously one by one comic scenes will be displayed on the drama, and that are having the happily end. Epic. An epic is the in the form of a verse. It is generally a long and narrative poem telling you of a hero's deeds. The best example of epics are Ramayana and Mahabharata. We all know that it is written in a verse form, and here it is a long epic in which all the deeds work is done by the hero and heroines. Okay, by the heroes, and what they did, everything is said in this poem. It is in the verse form. In the Ramabharata, we know that the childhood days are given, then their journey, their married life, and then the war between the Kaurav and Pandava, everything is given. So it was an epic, and it was in the form of verse, and it is a long and narrative poem which is telling us of our heroes did, what the hero are doing in this all it is said. Lyrics. A lyrics is a short poem which has the qualities resembling a song. Generally, we know that what is the lyrics of this song so that we can sing. So we find out this, okay? If we know the lyrics of the song or poem, then we can sing. So the lyrics is a short poem which has the qualities just like resembling a song. In that lyrics, if it is given, then we can sing it in a song form. Now the last is tragedy. A tragedy is a drama in which the protagonist, means lead character, the main character, faces a major loss, misfortune or a disaster. A tragedy is a drama in which the protagonist faces a major loss. He is having a major loss, misfortune, his luck is bad, and his disaster. And now a tragic play generally evokes terror or pity. It creates a terror and pity on the hero. So that in this tragedy drama, we will find that there is a tragedy with the main hero, with the lead character. So these were the literature from, and you should aware about it, that what is called novel, what is called poem, drama, short story, comedy and all. Okay? So now then I think that you understood very well that what was the poem and then what is given in it. Last is, I want to tell you about that in the line, "Dear Madam, you have seen this play, I ever saw it till today." It is the figure of speech which was used in this given couplet was NS Trophy, because the second sentence, "I ever saw it till today," is not in proper grammatical order. So we can say that it is a NS Trophy. Second, you know the details of the plot, but let me tell you, I do not. Internal rhyme, as I say you. And the second is litotes, because the poet has used the negative effect to convey his message. And you are not a friend of his. Here the again litotes is given in the first line. And internal rhyme is given, his and his. Okay, the word his and his is giving the rhyming words. The actors in their funny way have several funny things to say. Funny, funny is used, so internal rhyme and repetition are given. But they do not amuse me more. Here the again litoties are used in this line because the negative word is used to give a positive effect. And may I add one human touch? This is, I said actually, interrogation sentence words, mark is given there, so it is an interrogation figure of speech. The poet has used a question, but the intention is not getting an answer. He does not want any answer from the lady and for the viewers, okay, or for the readers. Don't breathe upon my neck so much. Here the synecdoche is used because the poet has used the word neck to describe his entire self. Okay, so here the synecdoche is used. So students, in today in this video I explained you the unit 4 at the theater. So watch it properly, learn it, and keep learning. Goodbye, till then we will meet again soon. Bye bye.